In this video, I am going to explain anatomy of pelvic floor muscles. On previous video, I explained deep layer of pelvic floor, such as levator ani and coccygeus. In today's video, I am going to explain more superficial layer, which is this muscle. Okay, this is from inferior view. Okay, these are levator ani. The other muscles are superficial layers. What is this kind of triangular shape muscle? This is deep transverse perineum. Deep transverse perineum. Okay, this kind of a triangular shape muscle. If there is deep transverse perineum, there should be superficial layer, right? So where is superficial one? That is this one. Okay, this is superficial transverse perineum. Superficial transverse perineum. That muscle kind of cross pelvis kind of horizontally. Okay, deep one is very broad muscle. Superficial one is very thin muscle. Okay, then what is these muscles? This is also thin muscle. This is closed to ischium. This is ischiocavernosus. Ischiocavernosus. Okay. This muscle is important for genital function. Okay. Genital function. And there is one more kind of a similar name muscle. By the way, this is female pelvis. Okay. There is muscle like this, this pink muscle. This is bulbospongiosus. Okay, bulbospongiosus. This muscle is slightly different between female and male. Remember, this is female pelvis. Male bulbospongiosus is slightly different. Ischiocavernosus and bulbospongiosus are important for genital function because look at that. These muscles are on the anterior part of pelvis, right? What are they? Genital organs are in front part of pelvis, right? Like this area. That is why these two muscles are related for genital function. Okay, next one. What is this one? This kind of a ring-shaped muscle. This is external anal sphincter. External anal sphincter. External anal sphincter. And there is one more external muscle, which is this one. This is external urethral sphincter. External urethral sphincter. These two muscles are related for urination and defecation, right? And if there is external anal sphincter and external urethral sphincter, they should be internal, right? Yes, there are internal anal sphincter and internal urethral sphincter. What is difference between internal and external? Okay. You can control external muscles. when you want to go to bathroom and you are away from home like 3 minutes, you need to hold that. Now you can control external muscles, but you cannot control internal muscles. These are like heart muscles or internal organ muscles that you cannot control that. Same like heart muscles, you cannot control internal sphincter. You can control external sphincters, okay? So these are external sphincters, okay? These are very, very important to distinguish. There is one important place. This is what? Bulbo spongiosus, right? And there's kind of a figure eight kind of connection, external anal sphincter and bulbo spongiosus. This place is very, very important. This place is like a meeting point of many muscles. What is this place? This is perineal body. Perineal body. This is very important to approach this place, maybe by osteopathic approach or maybe by body work kind of approach like Pilates, yoga, and myofascial release. I know this place is very sensitive because there's urogenital organs, but once you build credit between you and your patients, it's important work around here. But please remember, this area is very sensitive. You need to be very, very, very careful when you approach this area. Okay? This is anatomy of the superficial layer. So let me explain function of these muscles. As I explained deep layer anatomy of pelvic floor, functions of deep layer is mainly support. Support for internal organs. There is bladder, there is uterus, there is rectum, there is prostate, right? Deep layer is very close to internal organ. That is why these muscles need to support internal organs. On the other side, superficial layer is more related for defecation and urination and genital function. And these external sphincters are related for urination and defecation. Of course, these muscles have role for support for internal organs. But as name of muscle suggests, this superficial layer is more related for urogenital function. Genital function and digestive system. Okay, superficial layer of course supports internal organ, but this urogenital function and digestive system is more important for superficial layer. I know anatomy of this place is very, very complicated, and name of muscle is not very familiar, right? Like biceps brachii, biceps femoris, quadriceps. These muscles are more similar. But what is bulbo spongiosus and ischial cavernosus and deep transverse perineal? Name is very confusing, but again, this area is very, very important. Urogenital function, digestive system, it's crucial, right? That is why I recommend to memorize these anatomy terms. So in this video, I explained basic anatomy of pelvic floor. Particularly, I explained superficial layer. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.